for a meeting.
I don't have any time for you, lame boy.
Welcome back to Fever with me, Oliver Biscuit, the Lady Killer. Let's take your temperature. Oh, baby, you're frigid. Remember, it's Saturday.
Call Pet Stuffers. We'll be there within a week to pick him up, and in less than a month, he'll be back as good as new. Through an ancient Egyptian miracle process called taxidermy, you and your best friend will always be together.
Yeah, that's a good dog.
Pet Stuffers, when you just can't let go. And coming soon, grandparents forever.
Highlighted hair?
Vacant brain dead look in your eyes. Something missing?
Complete the look.
Complete the look with men's eyeliner at Vice City's one-stop shop for people who are cool when they cry.
Wow, you look ambiguous.
Complete the look.
I was losing myself in the music there for a moment. Forgive me. It just hit me so hard sometimes, like a massive bit of masonry falling from a high building or something, or a truck driving over your foot, you know? Powerful, like a dream where you go to work naked. Let's take a break while I recompose myself. Remember, too much emotion is always a good thing.
Howdy, partner. It's 4:30 in the morning here at Farewell Ranch, and it's time to get up and work the old cows. Get up, y'all! At Farewell Ranch, old people don't sit around stagnating, watching game shows, talking about the good old days, sinking into the grave in a urine-soaked mess. At Farewell Ranch, they sweat and toil until the breaking point, keep that miserable contemplation of mortality at bay. Hell, at steering time, we'll work Grandpa so hard he'll wish he was dead. At the end of the day, he'll sit down in the bluegrass, eat a bowl of commemorative beans, and enjoy sing-alongs at one of our nightly funerals. It's the cowboy's code. Work hard, don't shower, and die in your boots. Right, Norm?
My prostate.
Farewell Ranch, the only way to ride into the sunset.
We express emotion because you...
Oye, mira el culo en esa tipa, man.
Damn, I almost had his wallet.
The car park, the airport, the baggage carousel.
think that song says so much about the human heart, don't you? Or, as my people say, corazón. Tempted by the fruit of another. My people make the women's and the cars bounce up and down. You see, love is important, but so is the action. A real man needs more than one thing in life. Do you know what I'm saying here? The heart and the loins both on fire, no? Groaning and straining and making love and having hot, dirty, passionate encounters with the secretaries while the wife, she sleeps at home. I know, I have been there many times. You're on emotion, where the heart remains true.
You're going down! Waste him, we're always right. I've got a clear shot.
No wonder you ended up being a cop.
Save your breath. Give up.
He's out of control, Captain. He's mine. He's going down right now.
This is just like training. I see him! He's mine! I got him! I'll get him down.
To preserve the diversity of natural life, reuse everything.
Question, who's this we?
My coven.
Like witches?
No, yes, but not witches like you think. We're just a group of people who believe in communal sharing and chanting a lot and can't find husbands. Reading magazines, cloaks, wands, horned gods, rubbing your skin raw with rocks, dying of old age at 27, crying in terror when it starts to thunder. And these are all the things our ancestors did. Since I found my new mind and body, things have really changed for me. Our modern society only celebrates a select few. Every woman, every man is a star in the sky, Amy. Not just the ones that sing on TV or those people in the movies. I think I know what you need to separate your reflection from your true self. A Zen garden.
Oh, my brother had one of those and the federales came.
No. Zen, silly girl. It's a little sandbox you draw pictures in. It teaches you things like that death isn't an end. It's just a stage and also a beginning of a new journey.
Do you have a leader in this weirdo cult of yours?
Not a cult, a coven. There's a big difference. Yes, our leader's name is Phil.
That's a weird name for a leader of a group of witches. Oh, hi, Phil. What hairy legs you've got. What with being a man who's a witch and everything.
Do not disrespect Phil. He teaches us the wheel of the year, Amy. It's full of solar holidays and goes round and round and round. You can learn a lot from the sun and the moon. If you look at the sun for too long, you can go blind, meaning it is something to be respected. And the moon has a dark side. just like we do. And some people have craters and only a sixth of gravity. The ancient Britons knew the moon could breathe. We can change the world, rearrange the world. It's dying, though, Amy. And it needs some mouth-to-mouth resuscitation, like a swan or a fish on a hook. If you take your nervous system seriously, if you take your organs seriously and explore them, some really neat things can happen. Phil taught us that. He's been to Mali to meet with the village elders. That's why there's the ceremony of the knife.
Oh, great. Why does everyone have to be packing sharp things?
The knife ceremony is very important and spiritual. It's an ancient one-person personal crisis. You say to yourself, I'm going to have a spiritual experience, or thrust this thing into my head. Life actors never rehearse and need no script, Amy. That was said by somebody really spaced out, and I'm going to say it again, like the wind which keeps blowing, or the sun which shines with life.
Will you please leave? You smell, and you talk really weird, and you're just really gross.
Not until I tell people out there, become an internationalist. Learn oral traditions. Learn to respect life. Make war on machines. Marry your mother. Technology will enslave us. Buy my book! It's printed on bars.
Okay. Let's take a quick call. Hello, you're on K-Chat. What's your name?
Hey, it's Emmanuel from Front Island. I love the show. Yeah, I want to talk about technology enslaving us. You know that play, In the Future There Will Be Robots? Well, that's a true story. In the future, there will be robots. And I'm going to hack them all. I'll make them say funny things. You know, I can move satellites around with my computer.
Computers are evil. The Luddites of ancient Britain know this. That's why they destroyed the computers that created things faster and more efficient and took their jobs.
Oh, shut up. Computers aren't evil. It's the people that program the computers that are evil. That's a pretty big difference. I'm talking to you through a computer right now. In fact, I am a computer.
Well, anything that can think faster than me is evil. Anything which doesn't dance or sing or cry or wear a smock. You create your own reality. We are like the dust in the wind. We are golden. We've got to get ourselves back to the garden.
Okay. I know who you remind me of. My Aunt Susan. Oh, she was single too.
I'm not single, Amy. I share my life with a number of valuable partners, and we commune with each other in a non-judgmental, expressive way.
Old maid, my mom calls her. Anyway, let's go to the phones. You're on K-Chat.
Get on the phone,
yes. Thank you. Yeah, that was great. Really interesting. I'm British, you see.
Like our angel.